A film in 3 minutes, The Fisher King. Here's a question. What's the worst thing you've ever done? Like, seriously, the absolute worst thing. Did you ever steal from a friend, lie in court, or perhaps your actions led to the deaths of several people without you ever lifting a finger? And if such a tragic event happened in your life, just how far would you go to undo the damage you caused in the search for redemption? Because if your name is Jack Lucas, then you're about to find out. Directed by Monty Python legend Terry Gilliam, The Fisher King story revolves around radio shock jock Jack, played by Jeff Bridges, whose insulting on-air comments directed at a mentally unstable caller lead said caller into a murder-suicide at a Manhattan restaurant. Years later, washed up and dependent on alcohol, Jack's life hits a dead end until one night he is saved from muggers by a strange homeless man named Parry, played by Robin Williams, who believes he's a knight on a mission to find the Holy Grail, enlisting Jack to help him on his quest. For those oblivious to Gilliam's previous work, The Fisher King combines his trademark zany visual flair, which we can see in such films as Brazil, with a deeply human story grounded at its core by the themes of forgiveness and acceptance. Jeff Bridges is simply perfect as the Howard Stern-esque, acerbically arrogant turned suicidal radio host, who gradually realizes the consequences of his actions and seeks to do right in helping Parry search for the mythical grail. Robin Williams reminds us all of just how special a talent he was when playing the mentally deluded Parry, whose energy and slapstick humour work perfectly against Jack's uptight embarrassment and snobbery. But Jack's long-suffering girlfriend Anne, played by Mercedes Ruehl, is what gives the story its true emotional core, with her Oscar-winning performance reaching a crescendo in a heartbreaking scene when Jack thinks he no longer needs their relationship in his life. As the first film Gilliam made with no involvement from his fellow Pythons, The Fisher King is arguably his most commercial venture to date. But the director still manages to twist the setting of New York City into a more fantastical world for Jack and Parry to traverse through, utilizing bizarre locations such as a former armory on Madison Avenue as the castle where the Grail is allegedly kept. A magnificent scene where 400 extras perform a waltz in the city's iconic Grand Central Terminal perfectly encapsulates Gilliam's directorial flair at making everyday human situations appear more magical. And on a personal note, the scene itself is one of my favourite cinematic moments of all time. The Fisher King works on multiple levels. The end result is a mixture of love story, fantasy, comedy, and heartbreaking drama, with Robin Williams achieving one of the most moving performances of his career. Gilliam's ability to balance the disparate elements of the story makes The Fisher King a unique, quirky piece of cinema, with a visual style, creative approach, and heartwarming performances that will hopefully make you laugh as many times as cry, where its central message of forgiveness will remind us that people can change for the better if they truly desire to, and that sometimes it takes a fool to show a wise man just how foolish they are.